So very good morning to everyone. Please switch on the videos. Yes, a few have informed me about their network issue. That is okay. Others, please switch on the video. Yes, Karthik, Irfan, Anjo, please switch on the video. Okay. So, what is retirement, Anjo? Yes?
When the partner leaves on this firm.
Okay, very good. Okay, then that is retirement. One of the partner is leaving the partnership firm. That is called retirement of the partner. Then, what are the various adjustments we started with? First, we found out, we started calculating the new profit sharing ratio. Okay, then we moved to gaining ratio. To find out the gaining ratio, we had three situations. Then we discussed about treatment of goodwill. Can someone explain treatment of goodwill? Treatment of goodwill, how is goodwill treated? We had two situations, two cases where already a goodwill amount exists in the books or there is no goodwill in the balance sheet. Already there is no goodwill. So, how was it? We need to find out the goodwill, the share of goodwill belonging to the retiring partner, and that is distributed to him in the gaining ratio. Okay, and already if there is goodwill in the books that is written off, then the new goodwill, based on the new goodwill, we'll find out the share of the retiring partner and that is given to him. Remember? Okay, now let's continue. I hope we completed this Naresh, Rajkumar, Bishwajit problem. Did we complete? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, thank you, Anjo. Yes, we completed that. Now, I had given you a problem to try it from home. To do it by yourself, I know there is a little confusion regarding that. So before that, let me discuss another topic. Before going to that problem, let me discuss this. That is disposal of amount due to retiring partner. That means we know that a partner is retiring from the firm. So we need to pay him certain sum of money. How do we calculate that money? We prepare his capital account. The capital account of the partner is prepared. Then the adjustments are done. If there is any general reserve in the balance sheet, that has to be distributed. Profit and loss, accumulated profit, accumulated reserves. If there is a loss, all that should be adjusted. Okay? Then the revaluation profit or loss, that will be shown in the capital account. We'll adjust it. Okay, so after doing that, the balancing figure that we get in the capital account, that is the amount that belongs to the retiring partner. The other partners should pay him that particular amount when the partner retires. Okay, so now how do the other partners give this amount to the retiring partner? How is that handed over to the retiring partner? Okay. Either they can pay the complete amount, full amount at a single time. That is lump sum settlement. Okay? At a single time, they give the entire amount belonging to the retiring partner. Suppose if there is 1 lakh rupees, retiring partner is entitled to get 1 lakh rupees. So that is given 1 lakh rupees together, it is given at one time, at a single time. Okay? Or else, what the other partners do is, they can pay the same 1 lakh rupees in installments. Okay? So either in lump sum immediately or in various installments. And this installments, if it is decided to give it in installments, it might carry interest. Okay, interest has to be calculated in the remaining installment amount. You remember about interest we learned in the basic concept of partnership? If nothing is mentioned in the partnership deed, the interest on loan provided to partner, how much was that? The rate? Anyone who remembers? We had discussed certain rules when the partnership deed is silent, what to do with certain treatments. So, if nothing is mentioned in the partnership deed or the partnership deed is silent regarding the interest payable to the partner on loan, how much was the interest?
6%.
Very good. It is 6%. So, either the interest amount, interest rate is specified in the partnership deed. If nothing is specified, then I told you the amount payable to the retiring partner that can be given in installments. Based on the remaining amount, interest is calculated at 6%, and that interest should also be paid to the retiring partner. Clear till now? Yes? Okay, let's see the journal entries now. Okay. Again, the outgoing partner's account is settled as per the terms of partnership deed. Everything will be mentioned clearly in the partnership deed. Either lump sum means together as a single payment, the total amount is paid together. In case the firm is not in a position to make the payment immediately. So the firm is not in a position to make the payment immediately. There are two options. Partly in cash immediately and partly in installment. As I said, if there is 1 lakh rupees, okay, to be given to the retiring partner, so they are not in a position to give the 1 lakh rupees together. So what they do, 1 lakh rupees is to be paid. So 30,000 is given in cash first. The balance 70,000 is paid as installments. Okay. So that is partly in cash immediately. Immediately we give 30,000 and the remaining is given as installment. That is partly in cash immediately and partly in installment. Or the entire 1 lakh rupees can be given in installment. We are not giving the 1 lakh rupees, now either in as partly or nothing. So entire 1 lakh rupees will be paid to the retiring partner in installments. Okay. Then, in the absence of any agreement, Section 37 of Indian Partnership Act 1932 is applicable, which states that outgoing partner has an option to receive either interest at 6% per annum till the date of payment or such share of profit based on the capital ratio. If suppose any kind of profit is received by the firm making use of this remaining amount to be paid to the retiring partner, that profit is also should also be given to the retiring partner or the interest at 6% per annum. Okay. Now the journal entries. Please dig down and please switch on the videos. Nobody's video is on.
Ma'am, I have Wi-Fi problem.
Okay, Karthik, okay. Shubham, how about others? All are having network issues? Okay. When retiring partner is paid in cash full, please take down the journal entries. Full amount is given. So, retiring partner's capital account debtor to cash or bank. So, the full amount is given as lump sum. Lump sum payment is done. So, the retiring partner's capital account debtor to cash or bank. That is the first journal entry. Now, we are not paying it fully. When retiring partner's whole amount is treated as loan, that means it is treated as loan. Why? Because we are not paying it. We are giving it in installments. Then we transfer that amount. Earlier I told you an example of 1 lakh rupees. So we are not paying this 1 lakh rupees. The entire 1 lakh rupees is treated as loan and it is transferred to retiring partner's loan account. Okay? Retiring partner's loan account. Now, the third situation, when retiring partner is partly paid in cash and remaining amount treated as loan. So what happens? We will combine both these entries together. So partly, a part of the amount is given in cash. So retiring partner's capital account debtor to cash or bank, that is the amount paid. And the remaining amount which they have planned to make it in installments, make the payments in installments, that is transferred to retiring partner's loan account. Okay. So the first three journal entries are clear. Yes, Shubham?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, good. Okay. So the next one. Now we need to settle this loan amount. We need to make the payment of this loan amount now. Okay. When loan account is settled by paying in installment and it includes interest also now. Okay. So for interest on loan, when interest is due, then the journal entry is interest account debtor to retiring partner's loan account. When the interest is due, we need to calculate the interest based on the remaining amount which is paid in installment, paid as installment. So for interest on loan, interest due, that is interest account debtor to retiring partner's loan account. And now for the payment of this installment, when it is paid, it becomes retiring partner's loan account debtor to cash or bank. Retiring partner's loan account debtor to cash or bank. Okay. So this is how the payment is done to the retiring partner. So Anila, can you explain this? What are we doing with this amount payable to retiring partner? Yes, Anila, can you hear me? I think you are having audio problem. I can't hear you. Okay, so the amount payable to the retiring partner, either it can be given it as a lump sum amount or partly in cash and the remaining installment, or together the whole amount can be given as installment. Then if it is given in installment, that amount is transferred to retiring partner's loan account. Interest has also to be paid. Okay, that's all. Now let's see the problem. Digvijay, Brijesh and what is that name? P. Were partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio 2:2:1. And we are given, what is the name? Can anyone pronounce it? Please help me. How did you read it? Yes, Aparna, how did you read that?
Ma'am, is it paragraph?
I don't know. Anyways, Digvijay, Prijesh, and let us call him P. Okay, these three people, they were sharing profits in the ratio 2:2:1, and we know the balance sheet is given. Okay, then did anyone try to do this problem? I received only message from Aditya. She is the only one who sent me. Anybody else who did the problem? Who tried it? At least the revaluation account, you can do it your own. Yes or no? And how about your homeworks? I'm not receiving it. Anyway, we'll discuss it in the banking hour. Okay, so the balance sheet is given. In the balance sheet, you can see cash, debtor, stock, building, patent on the asset side. Then liabilities, creditors, reserves, Digvijay's capital, Brijesh capital, P's capital. Okay, that is given. Now, goodwill of the firm was valued at ₹70,000 and was not to appear in the books. So there is no goodwill in the books now. Bad debts amounting to ₹2,000 were to be written off. That means the liability increase. Patents were considered as valueless. Asset decrease. Prepare revaluation account. Before that, I want you to tell me the gaining ratio. What is the gaining ratio? What is the gaining ratio?
Oops, sorry.
What is the gaining ratio?
2:1. 2:1.
Very good. 2:1. Okay, so if you want to show it as the equation, how do you show it? Gaining ratio is equal to, what is the formula? Gaining ratio?
New ratio minus
old ratio. New ratio minus old ratio. So here, what is the new ratio? What is the new ratio? New ratio minus old ratio. What is the new ratio? Why no answer? Old ratio is 2:2:1. Okay. So, who is retiring? Brijesh is retiring. Am I right? So, we strike off that. This way, we got the gaining ratio, and that is same as the new ratio. In this case, new ratio and gaining ratio is the same. Okay? So, even if you want to apply it in this formula, you can use this as the new ratio, then old ratio is given and you can calculate it. Okay, then what is the share of goodwill? Let us find out that also in advance. 70,000 is given as goodwill amount. So how much should be given to the retiring partner? Retiring partner is Brijesh and his share is 2/5. Okay. So goodwill of the firm, 70,000 into 2/5. That will give you the share of goodwill to be given to Brijesh. Okay, now find out how much Digvijay and P should give him. The gaining ratio. They will distribute it in the gaining ratio. So how much? Are you doing it? None of your videos are on. How will I know what you're doing? Are you taking it down?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. So you have your accountancy periodic test on 2nd August 2nd. Am I right? Did you see the timetable? So you will be having admission as well as retirement death, both the chapters. Whatever I have taken. Okay? So portions for your periodic test, admission, retirement death. Okay, is this over? The working part over? So we found out what is the share of goodwill of the retiring partner, that is 28,000. Gaining ratio and new ratio is the same, 2:1. Now, this 28,000, how is it shared among the continuing partners? How are they giving it? In the gaining ratio. So 28,000 into 2/3. This is the amount contributed by Digvijay, and P is giving him this amount, 9,333. Is it over? Please let me know when it is completed. Now, those who have completed, please prepare the revaluation account. What are the items that will come in the revaluation account? Only two items: bad debts, patent. So bad debts over. This part is over. Hannah, did you finish? Okay. Hadi, over. Yes, Hadi. I cannot hear you. Basil, finish?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Okay, let's continue. Now, prepare the revaluation account. So what is happening to revaluation account? Bad debts, liability increase. So it is written on the debit side of revaluation account. To bad debts. Revaluation account debtor to bad debts. So 2,000 rupees, okay? Then patent, you can see the value of patent 9,000 in the old balance sheet, and in the adjustment it is said that it is becoming valueless. So the value of asset is decreasing. So we write it on the debit side, revaluation account debtor to patents. 9,000. Anything else to be written there? Nothing else. Okay. So, balance it. When you balance it, you can find that it is a debit balance. Debit balance means what? It is loss. Revaluation loss. Revaluation loss. And now that loss, in which ratio do we share it? Irfan, which ratio? Irfan?
Old ratio.
Very good. It is in the old ratio. So revaluation, profit or loss, whatever it is, we will share it among all the partners in the old ratio. All ratios 2:2:1. So those who have completed the revaluation account can prepare the capital account now. Now you can see in the old balance sheet there is a general reserve. What to do with the general reserve? Pavitra, what to do with this general reserve? General reserve, which is already appearing in the old balance sheet. What do we do with that? Yes, Aparna, what to do with that?
Ma'am, we are transferring it to capital account.
Yes, we cancel it, we write it off, we distribute it to the to all the partners in the old ratio. Okay. Then we know all the amount. Let us prepare it. Prepare the capital account now. First, on the credit side, buy balance brought down. What is that? 82,000, 60,000, 75,500? What is this amount? Hanna, what are they? Capital. From where do you get it? Old balance sheet. It is given in the old balance sheet. So balance brought down 82,000, 60,000, 75,000. Okay, that's done. Now, the goodwill that is received by the retiring partner, it is given by the continuing partners. So by Digvijay's capital, we already found out that Digvijay is giving 18,667 and P is giving 9,333. Okay, so that is this amount by Digvijay's capital account, by P's capital account. So this is the goodwill received by Brijesh, the retiring partner. Then there is a reserve. I told you, reserves, we are writing it off, we are cancelling it. So the reserve that is given in the balance sheet, that is distributed among all the partners in the old ratio. Okay, then how about the revaluation? Was it a profit? It was a loss. So loss, we will show it in the debit side. These amounts, they are the loss. So revaluation loss, 4,400, 4,400 for Brijesh, 2,200 for P. Okay. Now, we need to adjust the goodwill share in the continuing partners. Continuing partners are giving it out of their capital. It is from their capital they give the goodwill to the retiring partner. So, to Brijesh capital account, 18,667. Brijesh is the retiring partner. The goodwill given to him, 18,667 taken from Digvijay. And 9,333 taken from P. Okay? That's all. Anything else? Nothing. So what is the next part to do? What to do next, Shubham? So we have written everything. Now what is the next thing to do? Yes, Shubham, you there? Yes, Basil, what to do next? We have recorded everything. So what is the last thing to do? Yes, Basil, can you give me the answer? What is the next step? Final step. we balance it. We are going to balance this partner's capital account. So when you balance, the balancing figure, did you balance it? Did you finish? The balancing figure, Dig Vijay 66,333, Brijesh 91,000, and P 67,667. These are the balancing figure. Now, this balancing figure of Brijesh 91,000, this is the amount we have to pay him when he is leaving. Okay? That is what I said, when somebody is leaving, when a partner is retiring, we prepare his capital account, we do all the adjustment in the sense whatever has to be given, it should be given, deducted. Okay, so finally the balancing figure, this is the amount that the retiring partner should get. Now in this question, nothing is mentioned specifically what to do with this 91,000, whether it has to be given as a lump sum or installment, what is being done, nothing is specified particularly. So we transfer it to loan account, that means we are paying it in installment. Okay, when nothing is mentioned, and as I told you, nothing is mentioned, so if you get a problem, at the end you will write a note, whatever you are doing it. If suppose you felt like settling it in a lump sum, it's okay, but you should mention the capital of Brijesh is paid as lump sum immediately, and here we are transferring it to Brijesh loan account. Okay, yes or no? So 66,333, that is the balancing of Dig Vijay, and P, we have 67,667. These amounts will be shown in the as capital in the new balance sheet. Now let's prepare the new balance sheet. New balance sheet. So cash 8,000, nothing is happening to the cash balance. Cash 8,000, debtors it was 19,000, and we know there was a bad debt written off 2,000. So deduct 2,000 from that. So outer column you get 17,000. Stock, no change with stock, 42,000. Building, no change, 2,07,000. Coming to the debit side, creditors 49,000. Brijesh loan 91,000. That means the entire 91,000 has to be paid in installments now. They haven't paid it. So this is considered as loan. Considered as loan provided by the partner. Okay, we treat it as the firm has taken loan from the retiring partner. That is the meaning. Okay, so Brijesh loan 91,000. Then Dig Vijay's capital account, this is the balancing figure we received from partner's capital account. Again, P's capital, that is the also the balancing figure capital. So who are the absentees today? Tomlin is absent. Femina is absent. Atul is absent. Tomlin, Atul, Sharath is absent. Yes? Hadi is here. Basil was there. He left. Okay.